Good afternoon, friends. Today we are going to cover the topic of fracture of surgical neck of the humerus. So let's begin. The fracture of surgical neck of humerus is common in elderly women. It is usually caused by the fall on the shoulder and often the symptoms are minimal. It is the impacted fracture in most of the cases. Now, what is impacted fracture? As you can see in the image, if fracture is caused by the force, then that force will jam the both the parts of the bone like this. This force will push the bone in this direction. This force will push the bone in this direction. So these parts will be in the jam packed position. So this type of fracture is called the impact fracture. How to diagnose? The elder patient with history of fall and an x-ray will confirm the diagnosis. As you can see, this is the AP view of the x-ray, anterior posterior view, in which you can clearly see that there is a surgical neck of humerus fracture is there, and there is a special view is also there for this axial x-ray. This is a view of the axial x-ray, which is normally used to diagnose the humerus surgical neck fracture. Classification. Neer has classified this fracture into four types, and this classification is mainly done to plan the treatment. According to the type of fracture, they will plan the treatment, and in that they have considered the four part, which is located in the proximal part of the humerus, which is the shaft, head of the humerus, greater tuberosity and the lesser tuberosity. Depending upon the how many parts have been seen in the x-ray, they have divided it into two to four part fracture. For example, if we can see that four part like a greater tuberosity, lesser tuberosity, shaft and head, then it can be called as a four part fracture. Let's see. As it is shown in the table, in the two part fracture, only anatomical neck and the humerus will be there. In second category, surgical neck and the humerus will be there. Third, in the only greater tuberosity fracture will be there. In the fourth, in the only lesser tuberosity will be there. In the three part fracture, greater tuberosity and lesser tuberosity will be there, and you can see the three parts. Okay, and in the last four part, you can see the four bones, which is the head, greater tuberosity, lesser tuberosity and the shaft. So it is called the four part fracture. What is the treatment? In cases when displacement is not there, then only immobilizing the triangular sling is enough. If the fracture is non-displaced, then immobilization triangular sling will give a good results. But if the part is displaced, if the fracture is displaced, then there are various options available for the treatment. One of them is the percutaneous K-wire fixation. As you can see, these are the K-wires, and it is a percutaneous. They have been inserted through the skin under the image intensifier. In X-ray, you can see like this, and then immobilization will be given to 3 to 4 weeks. Second option is open reduction and internal fixation. In this, they will go for the specialized plating like a locking compression plate system. As you can see, there are the plates. It is a plate and there are screws which will stabilize the part. This is the second option in case of displaced humeral surgical neck fracture. And in the worst cases, when the part is completely broken, when the fracture fragments are in the multiple fragments, then they will go for the shoulder replacement. As you can see, the original shoulder has been replaced by the artificial shoulder, which is seen in this x-ray as well. So it is called the shoulder arthroplasty. What are the complications of this fracture? There are mainly two complications. One is the axillary nerve injury, which is also common in the shoulder dislocation. The main reason is axillary nerve is located near to the neck of humerus. So because of that, in cases of humeral neck fracture, axillary nerve injuries is common. And second is the shoulder stiffness. Because of the prolonged immobilization, the chances of shoulder stiffness is common. To prevent that, we can start the early movement of the shoulder as soon as pain permits. Now, second topic for today's video is the fracture of greater tuberosity of humerus. It is also common in adult, and the main reason is a fall on the shoulder. Normally it is undisplaced, but sometimes it can get displaced as well. The main reason behind the displacement is the muscle attachment. As you can see in the image, the supraspinatus muscle is attached to the greater tuberosity. So because of the contraction of the supraspinatus, the fragment can be displaced. How to diagnose that? Patient will be having history of fall. Patient will have a pain, swelling, tenderness, which is common in all the fractures, and the pain during movement. But AP view of the shoulder joint will confirm the diagnosis. As you can see in this AP view, the greater tuberosity is fractured. What is the treatment? In cases of undisplaced fracture, rest in the triangular sling is enough. 3 to 4 week of immobilization will be enough. But in case of displaced fracture, shoulder immobilization is given in abduction position. Now you must think this, why it is given in abduction. As you can see in this image, shoulder is kept in abduction and then immobilization is given. The main reason behind is this: when the shoulder will be in abducted position, the supraspinatus muscles will be in the shortened position. So shortened supraspinatus will not pull the fracture fragment, which is a greater tuberosity. So to prevent the displacement of greater tuberosity, shoulder will be placed into the abduction position, which is the shortened position of supraspinatus, and then immobilization will be given. Second option is the open reduction and internal fixation in cases of moderate to higher displacement. As you can see, the screw will be fixed and then immobilization will be given for 3 to 4 weeks. What are the complications? Painful arch syndrome is one of the most common complication. Now what is a painful arch syndrome? As you can see in the image, the painful arch syndrome is the condition in which patient will feel the pain during the shoulder abduction, and particularly range between 60 to 120. There are various causes for this pain, but in this case, the major cause of the pain is the reduced space located between the coracoacromial arch and the greater tuberosity, which we will see in the next lecture. Second most complication is shoulder stiffness. The reason is obvious, that is because of prolonged immobilization. I hope you are clear with the topic. Thank you.